The first command we're going to use in this tutorial is a touch command. This touch command can be used for creating multiple files or single files at a time. So let's start with using a single file. Just use a touch and then give a file name, anything that you need. The file has been created. Now, where does this file have been stored? So the file has been stored in the present working directory, the directory whatever we are working now. So the directory means the folder that we are working in. So we call it directory in Linux. You can see the directory by using command pwd. So pwd command tells us the directory that we are working. We are working in the Riaz directory. You can go to the manual GUI and you can see the file names there. The file names have been created like file 1, file 2, file 3, file 4, file 5. So our file has been there. Or you can just type simply ls and you can see the files and folders that have been created already. So there are other options like a, l and many more. We're going to discuss only two options that are required for ls. ls minus a. Minus a means that shows all the hidden files and files. You can see dot dot dot. So these dots are all hidden files. Yeah, it is necessary that the hidden file must be started with dot. All the files and folders that have been started with dot are the hidden files. We can create a hidden file. Just use touch dot file. We have a hidden file. You can use ls and check. We cannot see the file here. The hidden file dot file. This is a file that we have created, which is not hidden. Now if you use ls and minus a, you can see our file dot file here. And there is another option, minus l. L means long listing. So long listing means we have file permissions, usernames, date of creation and the folder name or the file name, you can say. So let's create multiple files using touch command. So we are using the touch command. Now let's just create multiple files. File 1 space, file 2 space, file 3 space. So we have used the touch command. We have created file 3 names of file 1, file 2, file 3. As you can observe, we already have file 1, file 2 and file 3. Just observe the timing and date that we have created. We have created this file at 18.2. Now if you are creating again, it won't overwrite the content. It changes the date. Touch, the file has been created. Just use ls and minus l. Now you can observe the time of creation has been changed. So you can see the file 1, 2, 3 is 18.9. But in previous, we have 18.2. So the next thing, we can create multiple files by using touch. We can create multiple files, touch file and have parentheses. The file from which to which, like if you want to start from 5, we can start. And then dot dot means 5 to how much. I want to create 5 files from file 5 to file 10. The files from file 5 to file 10 have been created. Yes, we have already file 5. The same condition it happens, just the time of the file creation will be changed. You can see the files. We have file 1 to file 10. And there is the command called man, which basically means manual of these Linux commands. Like a manual of some refrigerator when you buy, or like a manual of any electronic device. You just open the manual and read the instructions. How can we use that thing? Similarly, in Linux, we use man and type any command that you are confused with. Like if you are confused with pwd, you want to see more options available, you can just type man pwd. This is the manual page of pwd. There are options like minus l, minus capital P and many more. I mean minus l. So these options you can use along with pwd. If you want to practice, you can just use this and you can see whatever it happens. Just use Q for going back. So now we are back. We have used search command, man command and ls command. Now let's just move to the other interesting command. It is a history. What is history? Exactly does the history thing. It tells us what commands we have used until now. I have used 452 commands till now. I mean, if you are new to the Linux, you're using just now, you may have few commands. And there's one more interesting command known as clear. This clear command will clear the screen. Whatever commands you have typed, nothing available. It's just empty screen. So that's it for today. And please don't forget to subscribe. It motivates me to do more videos. If you like the video, give a like and comment in the comment section. See you in the next video. Bye bye.